The importance of furniture is felt by everyone. One of the things that completes one's house is furniture. These live load elements are a necessity, or rather the most crucial part of designing your interior space. This is the Homes and Construction Show, and my name is Hilda Kamkama. Today, we are at Mayondo Engineering Works. We are going to talk to Engineer Mayondo to dissect for us what we need to know about furniture. Or rather, why is there a lot of fakeness on the market?
You know, carpenter refers to the people that are doing woodwork related to the construction side. And we have the joiner, we have a cabinet maker, and so on. Mm. So for me, I call myself a woodworker.
Our worry is, why is it that we have a lot of fake furniture on the market?
Talking about fake furniture is kind of an opportunity for this country, because wood is one of the materials that we have in abundance. Mm. And as we have wood in abundance, so anybody can come in and start to do this field, this work. You don't need so much sophisticated equipment to start. And that's one of the reasons why everyone is coming in. And one of the other reasons is because people come into this, and majority are on-job trained. So the on-job trained, they don't get the basics and the theory or the technology behind the properties of wood. You will find that majority of the woodworkers we have on the market have not gone through the right training in order to do the production. So that causes some of the problems that we have in the sector.
Mm. With that said, Hajj, how can I identify furniture that is wanting or substandard?
There are just a few things. Mm. Number one, the material selection, the quality of the material. Is it dry? You know, wood is wood. Mm. And you will find that almost every wood is good. But how have you handled it? In Uganda, we are saying everything. You want good quality? It's mahogany. But we get it out of Uganda, we buy any wood, because none of the customers inspects the type of wood that is used to produce a product imported from China or Europe. Mm-hmm. It's a piece of furniture, so it's not mahogany. So what I would like to say is, the dryness, the material preparation, you know, everything gets spoiled in the preparation process. As you prepare it badly, it causes poor quality. Mm. So the surface preparation, or how the surface looks like, the joint connections. If the joints are not well made, you will see a number of products on the market. The way you identify it, that is made in Uganda, there should be filler in the joints, sawdust filled in the corners. That identifies a Ugandan product. But we can do it so well, we only lose it in paying attention to the detail. Mm. To be precise, it's the joint details, dryness of wood, and surface preparation.
Now, in an event we have purchased furniture, I've taken it home, what are those effects of the furniture that was made out of wood, which was not dry?
Okay, thank you. Furniture that is made out of products, or that are made out of wood that is not dry, mm-hmm. will definitely have so many defects. Mm. Number one, warping, twisting, shrinkage, cracking. There are so many. So it will misbehave in so many ways. You know, wood is almost living, a living thing throughout its time. It absorbs moisture and loses moisture.
Mm.
But the more you have at the beginning, if it is lost, you will have so many deformations in the process.
Mm.
So some of the defects are those ones that I've given you.
So what are some of the characteristics of legit furniture?
Legit furniture. Like I mentioned before, it's not how much varnish that has been applied. It is how prepared it is for the surface.
Mm.
It is the details in the joints, the corners,
mm.
the chamferings,
mm.
the rounding. If it is rounded, it should be rounded. If it's a square product, it should be square, or rectangle should be rectangle,
mm.
not skewed.
Mm.
So, you know, those are some of the factors that we find that kill our products. You find a chair that is standing with three legs, yet it is designed to have four.
Mm.
So these are factors that affect what we say we produce using very good materials, and we produce poor quality. So good should be dry,
mm-hmm.
should be well prepared, joint attention to details in terms of the joints.
Mm-hmm.
As you inspect any piece of furniture, don't look at it from a distance. Come close, look at the joints. If it shows you filler inside,
mm-hmm.
you will get to know that even the joint inside is open.
Could you please highlight for us some of the standards that are required by maybe every carpenter to follow to ensure that they don't exploit the consumer?
You have mentioned both UNBS and exploiting the consumers and the carpenter. Number one, the standards are being sold by UNBS. The only challenge is nobody is buying them, reason being they are not required by the market.
Really?
You have never asked for the standard when you are buying a dining table. But when you are going to buy milk in a supermarket, you check whether there is
expiry date,
Q-mark.
Yeah, but...
Do you get that?
Yeah, even so, bread.
Even
you
bread.
Ask them, is it fresh? When was it baked?
Uh-huh.
When is the expiry date?
Exactly, and it does not enter the supermarket unless there is a Q mark. So UNBS has enforced on that side. On our side,
mm-hmm.
it has been... I wouldn't like to use the word neglected,
mm-hmm.
but it is not yet enforced. Maybe
mm-hmm.
we pray that the standards will be enforced and everybody should be able to follow the right procedures,
mm.
the right qualities,
mm.
and we do the right job.
Mm.
Because this is hurting us all. We are moving very fast and we are requesting government to help us to pass and put their reservations for the furniture sector,
mm.
so that we can avoid importation of furniture in the country.
Mm.
But as we get the reservation, they say no more importation of furniture to Uganda. So the government parastatal will go to somewhere, I wouldn't like to mention places, and will buy the worst. And they say, we bought Uganda, boo-boo.
Mm.
And the things are getting falling apart, and it is not only that institution that loses money, it is not only that company that is having the problem. We are getting affected because the poor quality will lead to no more purchase from Uganda because we produce poor quality.
Mm.
So it is affecting all of us.
Wood is way expensive than all these other products or the other products that we have or furniture. So what do you say about that?
This is a reality. Actually, we have not embraced wood properly in Uganda because maybe the way we work upon it. But when you talk about a premium product, you talk about a product you should be proud about. Mm. If you want a well-finished floor, it should be wooden. So wood is not for the poor.
Mm.
It is a premium product. So wood is supposed to be expensive.
Wood is supposed to be expensive. My question here is going to be, why do many people are actually drifting out from wood to other products like aluminium and steel?
Mm-hmm.
What could be the main cause?
The main cause is still poverty, I would say. But you cannot compare a wooden product with a steel product. I told you, you want premium, it should be wood. Tell me, go to your dining, make it out of steel and enjoy it. It will be cold.
Mm.
It will not have the same feeling as a wooden dining table. So wood, I would say, is premium. So the only challenge that I would like to tell you, actually, people are not, maybe on the other side, is that the other factor would be that we are giving poor quality. But I wouldn't like to base on that so much. The price is a factor. But quality, maybe if we some of the products are not standing the time or giving us the good quality that is expected, it could be a cause. But if well done, wood is supposed to stand out. If you would imagine a wooden window will be a little bit more expensive than an aluminium window, but the house fitted with a wooden window should be high class. Not apart, everybody.
Apart from high class and the premium bit of it, what are other advantages of wood over the other products we've gotten?
Advantages of wood. I would like to repeat and say that there are so many reasons as to why wood is better. Wood, when you touch wood, the feel is totally different. And wood is the material that can be, if we are talking about renewable resources, so wood does not, it can be used over and over in different ways.
Really?
You can use wood for a piece of a door today, and then tomorrow you dismantle that door and use it for something else, then you use it for something else.
That is possible.
And if you decide to throw it out, it will decompose and into the ground. So environmentally, wood is better than most of the materials.
You mentioned the design as a part of the components that determine prices. Many of us see different designs and we want them in our homes. The question here is, how do you get the designs on our furniture?
Two things. Number one, the client comes in with a design. It is our role to put it out. But still, this takes us back to training. Most of the people that are into production, you will find that he or she has not learned any drawing, has not learned any design. Design, I cannot do anything to do with the design. But on the other side, the right way to do it, or the way we do it at my own, whether you come in with your design, we try to draw it and present to you, Are you sure this is what you want? Then you will confirm that this is really what you meant. And then you proceed to produce. So the design process starts maybe with your design, or we can propose a design and then you confirm and then we produce. The beauty on the other side, we also have the capacity to use the computer-aided design and the computer-aided machine.
But still you see some element of computer-aided machine.
Mm.
So, and as you look at that, you can be sure that we can produce to international standards.
Yeah, true.
This is how much you can get from Uganda. It is really Uganda, we can make good products.
Mm.
So everybody should work hard and help this sector to take its position. Otherwise, the Chinese are taking our position and we are not well represented.
They may not be able, as we are getting now to know, really. Mm.
As you look, these are mahogany products.
Mm-hmm.
All of them are mahogany. And what makes these products stand out is the fact that they, when you look at the details, look at the joint details, they really, really stand out.
Mm.
When you look at the surface preparation,
it's
we don't have that thick material, the ordinary varnish that is used in the production of some of the cabinets or the furniture.
Mm.
So we use matte finish, and you appreciate the wood the way it is in its natural form. If the client needs that thick varnish, we can do it. But our style, we have adopted this one.
Mm.
So
all these other designs that you do here?
These are not all.
Some.
These are some of the few we do.
Mm.
And as the client comes in, we decide what we want, or we decide according to what the client wants. So we keep on changing designs. And this showroom of ours is not having all the products that we have made. You know, we came to realize that as we keep so much of the products in the showrooms, money kept seated. And on top of that, it is a challenge whereby the client will always say, I want, this is a nice door, but can you make the other two panels a bit bigger?
Like more deeper.
Can you make this one smaller? And that kills it.
Mm.
Look at the surface finish of this.
This is also matte, or it's glossy now?
This is semi-matte.
Okay.
Semi-matte.
Okay.
So this is a kitchen cabinet, and this is unique to my own.
How unique is it?
Look at the processing.
Mm.
If you have ever seen a cabinet shutter with that
carbined, a little bit. Mm.
That is particularly done by us, and it's not everywhere.
So how is it opened?
Oh, this brings us to this. This is a handleless kitchen. Depreciation is higher. You have a metallic handle, but after 6 months, maybe another design is there and you no longer need it.
Okay.
Will you change?
No.
But if it is this, so you, we provide for you this detail for your finger handling, and you don't touch the surface as you open.
Mm.
So it makes it so easy.
To open and close.
For you to open and close.
Yeah, because I see
even
the same applicability.
Cabinets, it is handleless. And this handleless style is the contemporary way of woodwork. The old style, we have that bling so much.
Because actually everywhere I'm seeing it's the same thing.
We try to do wooden, either wooden handles or handles.
Mm-hmm.
So this is having at least stainless steel handle, but with such accessories.
Let me do it. It's so heavy.
Yes, it has springs in it,
mm-hmm.
and it goes almost automatic up, and it will.
It comes down automatically.
Yes.
Lovely. This is a great initiative.
So, kitchen cabinets, we have quite, we can do quite a lot. This is just some of the few we can do.
Mm.
By the way, you will realize that most of the products you are seeing here, they are hardwood.
But yeah, I'm actually saying
hardwood, but we can do anything wood. Talk about MDF, particle board, gypsum board. This is one of the, I told you about knowing about the principles of wood.
Mm.
Many people think if I have a white piece of timber at once, it's better.
Mm.
But the principles of wood is that timber can shrink, can expand, can twist.
Mm.
So you need to play with
can be combined.
Small pieces of timber.
Mm.
And you get more stability if you have a lot of this.
Mm.
Actually, you will find most of our products are having that. And it is one of the things that makes us stand out.
I have to say that this is really commendable.
So you will look at a product like this. I don't know whether the camera has picked it up, but you will see so many small pieces of wood and bringing them together, and the joint details, the finger joints.
Yeah.
These are things, or these are details that not every woodworker would like to waste time on. That's why I told you that someone has got to look at the left-hand side of the quotation.
Which
is in the detail?
Yeah.
Before you ask what is in the price. Look at the shutter behind you.
This
you
one,
see
true.
Those leapings and the detail, and you know, it is well done.
And then when I look at this, I mean, it's really magical.
It's time put in. So if you really need the product to be good, you need to give it time. And if I put in the time, you have to pay me. I need money.
Mm.
Yes, I need money.
So time equals money, indeed.
Exactly.
And these.
So this is a plate rack. It's unfortunate you found when we have.
So it seems wood has very, very many
applications,
because now this is an aquarium.
Yes.
Trust me, I'm coming for it. I'll award myself.
These are wardrobes and with a trouser rack. So you can have so many trousers.
We still tell you that buy Uganda, build Uganda. With wood, you cannot go astray. With wood, you cannot make a mistake. You can't go wrong, because this is number one guarantee that you're going to get that 95% of what you're using is here. Durability is guaranteed. Thank you for being with us from where we started from up to now. We have learned about wood as one of the means of having our furniture in our homes, our buildings, our offices. You've seen it all. It is an amazing journey, very beautiful. Authenticity. You all find this on the Homes and Construction Affairs show. My name is Hilda Kamkama, and from me and my entire crew, we say, may God bless you, and we shall see you next Sunday with another amazing topic.